I'm Micah Smith, and we're going to take a look at some of the top tips for newbie developers. To explain some of these concepts, I'm joined by Jon Stueve. Jon Stueve is a training manager here at Automation Anywhere. So what's our second tip for new developers, Jon?
Every time somebody first builds a bot, they make a mess, an error. The bot doesn't run correctly, or the bot's not, bot agent might not be corrected. And they quickly click through the error message. And then they go, something happened, I don't know what it was. So it's really good to coach them early to read the error messages. There's lots of information that's helpful. Which line is the problem? Now, the problem might not be on that line specifically, but it gives you a place to start. And then you want to make sure you're solving for what that error message says. If the error message says that a variable has the wrong type, then that helps you to be able to mitigate that error. And another thing with our software is look at the UI, and especially the UI prompts around certain fields or selections. There's usually a small gray light font that tells you, it gives you what the UI is looking for. It could be the a key in a dictionary, or it could be, you know, this is for that. Read those prompts, because it really helps to understand what the technology is asking for.
And, you know, one thing I would point out that I really like about the UI is that we now have symbols for those different data types. So as you're working with different variables, and as you go to fill them in a field, if you see the two quote marks, you know, that one's probably not a number, it's going to be a string. And so definitely pay attention to those small visual cues, because they can really help you as you're starting to build out. And the other thing kind of along those same lines is whenever I'm choosing a variable, I'm always hitting F2 and bringing up that variables explorer.
I completely agree. Those visual cues for variables are important, because you need to know what that field is wanting. Is it a string? Is it a number? Do I need to cast the number into a string inline? So really knowing what those variable keys are. And also, like you said, we have that F2 key in the variable list for a reason. It cuts down on the number of typos. So use that F2. It's like a tab completion in some other formal languages, but it keeps you using the variables as they're defined, and not letting your sloppy typing to get in the way.
Final thing I would say on that is that if you are of the type that likes to build packages, make sure that you're using all of the labels that are available. Use those labels to guide the people who are going to be ultimately using your packages. Because it's just going to make it a lot easier for them. So as Jon was mentioning, if you can put some kind of sub-label there that indicates, you know, what the valid responses are, or what kind of data is expected, or the formatting details, that can only help people to better use your package if you're doing package development.
Yeah, the best thing about our tool is that it's very intuitive, and it leads people through it. So if you're adding something custom, keep with that style. Understand how the style is in the tool, make yours match, because people are going to use your package, and it's going to feel just as organic as the packages built by AA.
Be sure to follow us on YouTube. Be sure to follow us on our developer portal at developer.automationanywhere.com and on Twitter.
What I'd like to do is tell you about Automation Anywhere University. The website is university.automationanywhere.com, and it is our portal for all things learning. We have free courses, online self-paced courses for bot developer and citizen developers, as well as business analysts, so you can better understand what makes a good robotic process.